And now, with a report on support for patients undergoing cancer treatment, here's our Laura Windsor.
In dealing with the fear and anxiety of having been diagnosed with cancer, Hope Memorial Hospital Presbyterian in Newport Beach offers a support program that helps their cancer patients through this difficult time. We spoke with Catherine Bailey, a licensed clinical social worker at Hoag, who discusses the program and the patient support they offer.
The program is very comprehensive. It's designed to meet the needs of patients and families throughout the whole trajectory, from time of diagnosis through treatment and through survivorship issues. We have educational programs, we have support groups, we have a program called Fitter Image, which has a number of exercise programs, yoga, strength training, Pilates mat classes, etc. When a person comes in, they're not just a body being treated for cancer. They're a person who brings with them who they are as an individual. So we want to address everything from the mental, emotional, physical, spiritual. So our program is really designed to meet that. It really complements the care that patients are receiving from their physicians.
How do the patients learn about the program?
They get to us in a number of ways. They might be referred by their physician's office, one of the nurses, or the physician themselves. They might have a friend who went through cancer treatment at our center and say, you please go and check out all the different programs that they have. They might be coming into the center, the cancer center itself, which is a freestanding building. We have flyers, we have all kinds of things announcing the different programs and what's available.
When are the patients introduced to the program?
Most of the time, people are introduced to the program at the time or shortly after they get a cancer diagnosis. And once they've gone through many of those decision-making processes with their physicians about, okay, what kind of treatment am I going to be receiving? Will I get surgery? When will this all begin? How often? There'll be sometimes a lag time for people, and then all of a sudden they'll go, wow, I'm really scared, or I want some more information. I'd like to know what else there is for me out there to help me and my family get through this process. And that's where we come in, and that's how people will get to us, and we will say, okay, what are some of the things that we could help you with? We really let them tell us what they need and direct it. It's not like they walk in and we say, okay, here are all the things that you will need to do. It's really a matter of, here are all the things that we have to offer. You can pick and choose the things that most fit you as an individual. Because in coping with a cancer diagnosis, be it the patient or the people that support them, there is no one size fits all. So some people like a support group. Some people say, I've always been very active, but I don't feel like going to my gym anymore, or I'm embarrassed because I've lost my hair. And what can I do? And that's when we can offer them the classes that we have in a safe environment that adjusts for whatever limitations they might have. I had a woman who, one of the programs, workshops that we do is we have a meditation for stress reduction, because managing stress and coping with all the stressors that go on is important. And so she went through this 4-week educational program, and she came back to a monthly program that I do, and she said, I have to tell you what happened. She said, I went for one of my scans recently, and I started thinking about the things that I learned in the class. She said, and I used them. I worked on deep breathing and thinking about, she said, in fact, in my head, I went to Hawaii. And she said, it was the first time I went in, I went through the scans, and it was actually not a bad experience. So for me, that's like, perfect. We've given her the skills to be able to cope.
Support is key to help the patient and their family manage the physical, emotional, and lifestyle effects of cancer and treatment. For the American Health Journal, I'm Laura Windsor.